Once the process is finished, we can now close the window and we see that our virtual band has been added onto the list. So we shall ensure that we deselect all the other bands. All the other bands from the original image. And then we shall put a true color composite of the virtual image. And this we shall do by going to the properties and changing the band combinations. So the red band, we shall give it to band number 3. The green band shall remain band number 2. And then the blue band, we shall give it to band number 1. Then we shall apply and click OK. We therefore now have a true simulation of the situation on the ground and how the fields look like. We can take our study area to the top so that we are able to see the boundaries of our fields. And there we are. So we now have a true color composite of the Sentinel-2 images, or the Sentinel-2 image rather, indicating all the fields of on the ground. The next step will be to establish the field boundaries and the area of the fields from satellite images. These shall then be compared to the fields that have been recorded by the farmers. To do this, we shall create a shapefile, and this shapefile, I shall give it the name of the fields. So the fields are called LDC Olngatongo. The geometry shall be a polygon. For the coordinate system, we shall import the already existing coordinate system from the other shape files. And then we shall start adding the fields. So the first field, of course, will be the field name. You'd like to know what the name of the field is called. It will be a text. And then we shall add it to the field list. Another important one will be the field area, which gives the size of the field. And this, we can put it into a decimal number. We can add as many attributes as we may wish to capture. And once we are through with that, we click on the OK. You see that the newly created shapefile is added onto the list, onto a list on the QGIS. And so now we can start digitizing and adding features onto it. We shall now begin by digitizing the fields as they appear on the Sentinel-2 images and adding these to the Olngatongo shapefile. To do this, we shall start editing, and then we shall add polygon. We shall begin with this first one. And then once we finish, we right click, give it an ID of 1, and call it H1, which is the field name. We proceed with the next one. Right click, give it ID number 2, and give it a field name of H2. We proceed this way until we've digitized all the fields of interest within the study area. Once this is done, you can right click and open the attribute table, and you will see whatever has been digitized. What now we can do is to calculate the area of the fields. We select the fields that have been digitized, and then we come to the Open Field Calculator tool. We create a new field where we call it the field area. It will not be a whole number, but rather a decimal number. We can put it to 3 decimal places. We go to geometry. We want to calculate the area, double click. And the area is in meters squared, but we want to convert it to hectares. So we'll divide it by 10,000. And you click OK. This gives us the area of all the fields in hectares. This resulting field area is what now shall be compared to what the farmers have recorded in their field management books as being the area of these fields. Once you're finished, we stop editing and we save the edits that are there. Once all the fields have been digitized, the areas generated from the Sentinel-2 images can now be compared with the areas that have been generated by the farmers and recorded in their farm management books. The areas derived from the Sentinel-2 images shall now be extracted and compared to the areas that had been reported by the farmers in the farm management books. These areas shall be prepared in a format which is legible to the R statistics software, as this is the software which shall be used to analyze the differences between the measured and the reported field areas by the farmers.